Today, we're at the Singapore Zoo. You might be able to tell.
So we are. One of my favorite all-time subjects for slow motion, ever since I started doing it, is just the natural world, especially animals.
Yeah. Today, we're going to be focusing on fast reptiles, more specifically, how they eat.
We've got some speedy munchers in there. So why don't we go and take a look at our first one?
All right.
When I think of fast-moving animals, you can't ignore a chameleon. A chameleon tongue, rapid.
It's like a blink of an eye, which is the perfect subject for what we like to do.
So what's this puppy?
It's the Parsons chameleon.
Not a puppy.
Not a puppy.
It's a chameleon.
That's misleading.
We've got the Phantom Flex 4K. We'll get a lovely, glory high-res shot at 1,000 frames a second. And the V2512 over there, he's hanging out about 8,000, just for the impact and things.
Should we feed him?
Let's feed him.
I'm excited.
And what's he going to be eating?
Dead crickets here on the end of these forceps.
I think he'll go for it. He looks pretty hungry.
Yeah? How does a chameleon look hungry?
You can see it in his eyes.
That looks good to me. That looks good to me. There you go.
Oh, God.
Nailed it.
All right, he's hungry.
He really is.
He's teasing the tongue out there.
It's like a coiled spring.
Oh, here he goes.
Oh, that's so... Whoa!
Whoa.
Jeez. It is like the acceleration is incredible because it's like a big fat thing coming out slowly and then suddenly it just ejects it.
And you can see the rigid rod in the tongue.
Oh, I didn't know that was the thing.
Yeah, so that's where he gets his propulsion and he just blasts the tongue off and this is all just soft and sticky.
I didn't even know that.
And he's in. Snap. Should we have a look on this one?
Yeah.
All right, here it comes.
Oh, it's so, like, it's disgusting.
That is just evolution. Look at that.
Because you don't really see the chameleon, you just don't know what's going on.
From the way that smushes and squishes, I can very much picture what that would feel like. So weird.
It's one of the weirder things we've seen.
Yeah. Very cool. He's a hungry boy, isn't he?
He really is.
Apparently, he's got enough belly space for another go. So we'll film it again.
Sure.
How do you feel about holding the cricket yourself?
So you want me to do that? After I just said that was one of the most disgusting things I'd ever seen. Absolutely, I'll do
it. There we go.
Got a cricket right in my pocket ready. So I'll stick it in. Hopefully, he'll munch right on it.
He seems to be favoring the left side. So maybe we'll have him come right to left this time. Just stick it right in front of him. And I'm going to go closer up.
All right. OK, I'll stick it in and see if he munches it. Oh, he's nailed it. God, that was a weird thudding feeling against that. All the glistening on the moisture of the tongue from the light.
I love it.
Oh, so gross. Oh.
Oh, here he goes.
Look at the veiny, like, tongue. It's so weird.
Get it, son.
It's got quite a range on him, actually.
Oh, look at that.
So weird. Just kissing it. Oh, it, like, he took it further than the forceps. It's like a hand grabbing it, because it like envelops the insect. Lovely bit of food.
If the grasshopper was alive, he'd be going, ah!
Yeah. Oh, look, he's blinking. He's like, get in there.
Got it.
Yummy.
It's so fast.
If you could have a tongue like this, would you?
Probably not.
No? You don't have to get it out all the time.
It would only be good if I was opposite someone who was eating cereal, and I could just take individual bits without them knowing. Dan, how do you feel about snakes?
Actually, I'm fine with them. Considering I grew up in the UK, none of them can actually kill you or really do you any harm.
I don't think I ever saw one in England. This is the Gaboon Viper, one of the fastest striking snakes in the world. If you scale it up, it can move its head around 6 meters per second, which is mentally fast.
So blink and you'll miss it.
Literally blink and you'll miss it, because the average blink lasts around 220 milliseconds. This can get its head up to speed within 50 to 90 milliseconds.
Wow, well, luckily we've got some cameras.
Luckily our phantoms don't blink, or not that I've seen anyway. Look how well camouflaged it is too.
I know, it's really cool. They usually eat things like rats and birds and even antelope and monkeys, fresh out of monkeys. So we're going to give it a dead rat.
Dead rat.
Hopefully see its striking action. It's actually got the longest fangs of any snake, up to 5 centimeters.
I feel like this snake is breaking all the records.
It is, isn't it?
All right, snake is ready to strike.
Oh, he's moving a little bit. I think he's getting a bit excited here.
Oh, oh my God.
God.
You know what? I missed it. I blinked and I missed it.
That's so true.
Oh,
flipping heck.
The whole thing is in its mouth.
That's crazy.
All right, here we go. Playing that back.
Oh.
So fast, it kicked up all the mud.
That's so scary.
That is nature.
Wow. That was nuts.
What's interesting is, like, the speed he shoots off, watch as it kicks up all of this mud where he was, he's already coming back with the mouse while this is still moving forward.
He's, like, bashing the mud that he moved forwards with his face. One fang goes in and the other one's still out.
To be fair, if I had two fangs and I could control them like that, it makes sense to, like, walk the food into your own mouth. That's so cool.
I don't think I'd want to be doing what he's doing, actually. Funnily enough.
Bit scary. He's got a glove on there.
Oh, my God.
That was quick.
He just went.
God. And that was instant.
He didn't mess around.
He's
and
got
it was
a taste
longer as well. Oh, yeah.
Right into the back.
Chomps it. Whoa.
That was so fast.
I wasn't expecting it that quick either.
So the fangs go in, and then it's like, because of the angle, they're hooked like this way, so it must be absolutely impossible to come out. That was a really good strike. That's right, we're talking about you.
Don't talk to it like it's cute.
It is cute.
You just saw what it did to that rat.
No, it's just nature.
Oh, that's fair.
There is an animal that some people consider to be very ugly. It spends most of its time hardly moving, occasionally breathing, and just blending into the background.
Come on.
Not talking about you, don't worry. Oh. Talking about the mata-mata turtle.
So you want to film something in super slow-mo that spends so little time moving, it literally grows moss on its back.
Doesn't sound like a good subject for slow-mo, but its gob and the way it eats is very, very fast. Let's take a look.
All right. Oh, that was quick.
Oh, my God.
Goodness me.
That was absolutely instant. All right, let's watch that back. Oh.
Whoa.
Oh. Just absolutely sucked right in. It seems to expand all of its throat for, like, even more suction.
I like to do sound effects for that. Do you see its side of its mouth? Like, the little corners. Look at that. It's got like a little hinge on the side.
It's almost like there to funnel the water in smaller so that it has more pressure.
And then its mouth like folds over itself.
Yeah. I like his little pig nose.
I like it too. It's really cute.
Yeah. I like how ugly creatures can be so cute.
He is cute. Like that's now full of water and a little fish, and then it's just going to slowly let it out of his mouth.
So that probably just shoots straight into the stomach.
I wish I could do that.
Just sit down at a table. Check, please. You know what? I've also noticed at the end of that, he just fires out some
guff,
some of the extra pap. Love it.
My impression is this.
That's good.
Yeah. Out of all of those, which one would you pick to have your like eating mechanism? Out of all of them?
Probably the mata-mata turtle, just so I could just suck stuff up whilst underwater.
If you're walking like past the market stall or something, you should be like,
imagine having a bowl of cereal as that turtle just be like,
I love
just
that.
Gone. And then like the milk just goes. That was actually a very challenging shoot because you can never predict what animals are going to do. But I think we got some pretty interesting looking footage. Definitely footage you can learn from. That's what's important.
Yeah, I know, right?
Hopefully you enjoyed that video. Make sure you check out part two. We'll be learning a lot more about how all those animals work and do their business. And feel free to subscribe to the Slow-Mo Guys. There's your buttons over there.